In the previous video, we discussed about lenses. Now let us quickly revise before starting the new topic. Convex lens is thicker at middle as compared to the edges. Concave lens is thicker at the edges as compared to the middle. Then convex lens is converging in nature. All the rays are converging at a point. So it is called converging lens. Concave lens is diverging in nature. You can see that the rays are diverged. Now today we'll discuss certain terms like optical center. We know what is pole in a mirror. Pole is the center of the mirror. Similarly, the optical center, it is the center point of the lens. It is the center point of the lens. Next is center of curvature. What is center of curvature of a mirror? It is the center of the sphere of which mirror is a part. Similarly, here we have two spheres because we have two spherical surfaces. One is this spherical surface and the other is this spherical surface. Now complete the sphere of this spherical surface, you get a center. Complete the sphere of this spherical surface, you get another center. So you have two centers of curvature here. Similarly, in concave lens, you have two centers of curvature. Okay, we denote it by C1 and C2 or 2F1, 2F2 because the radius of curvature is 2 times the focal length. Therefore, we can write C1 as 2F1. The next is principal axis. It is the imaginary line which joins two centers of curvature. Then next, principal focus of convex lens. We know what is principal focus of mirrors, right? This is just for reference, this is just for comparison. This is a concave mirror. The rays which are parallel to the principal axis, they are converging at a point called principal focus. So similarly, the rays which are parallel to the principal axis after refraction, they converge at a point which is called the principal focus of the convex lens. Okay, there is actually meeting, the rays are actually meeting at the focus. So here we have real focus. In case of convex mirror, what happens when the rays are parallel? They are diverged from a point, and that point is called, they appear to diverge from that point, and that point is called principal focus of convex mirror. And since they appear to diverge from that point, it is called virtual focus. The focus is virtual in nature. Similarly, in concave lens, the rays which are parallel, after refraction, they diverge, and it appears that the rays are coming from one point. This point is called principal focus of concave lens. Now remember, the mirrors and lenses, they are very similar. Concave mirror and convex lens, they are very similar. They are similar, and convex mirror and concave lens similar. So if you know mirrors very well, you will understand lenses also well. Okay, now next is focal length. Focal length, it is the distance between pole and focus in case of mirror. And similarly, in case of lenses, it is the distance between optical center and focus. Now we know that the convex lens is of converging nature. This activity demonstrates this. Now what I'm doing, I have holded a convex lens in my hand, and I'm focusing the sun's rays on the convex lens. Okay, aur dusre hand mein maine ek paper hold kiya hai, and I'm trying to get bright image of sun. I'm trying to get sharp image of sun here. Sharp, bright image of sun. So actually what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to find a point where all the rays will converge. Or in other words, I can say that I'm trying to find focus of the convex lens. Right? So hume jaise hi wo ek bright image, sharp image mil jayega, aap usi position ko, paper ki usi position ko note kar lo, okay? You will not change the position of paper and lens, and then you will measure this distance, the distance between lens and the paper. and this is called focal length. जो भी हमने कहा focus distance between focus and convex lens, it is the focal length. तो आप वही कर रहे हैं, दोनों के बीच में distance find कर रहे हैं and you will be able to find focal length of convex lens. Fine. Okay, now rules for formation of images by lens. First rule is the ray which passes through the optical center goes without deviation. There is no deviation. It will just pass. जैसे सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर मिरर में सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर एक ऐसा पॉइंट होता है जहां से कोई चेंज द रे रिट्रेसेस द पाथ आफ्टर रिफ्लेक्शन राइट लेकिन ऑप्टिकल सेंटर से जस्ट पास होता है आप नोट वन थिंग दैट हियर यू विल ड्रॉ टू ऑपोजिट एरोज वन इज फॉर द इंसिडेंस द अदर इज फॉर द रिफ्लेक्शन लेकिन यहाँ पे आप दोनों एरोज का डायरेक्शन सेम दिखाएंगे बिकॉज यहाँ पे रिफ्लेक्शन नहीं हो रहा इट इज जस्ट पासिंग Okay, then next is a ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis. It will meet at focus in case of convex lens. ठीक है, concave lens में क्या होगा? The ray which is parallel to the focus, it will diverge and it will appear that it is coming from this point, focus. That means. Then next is for convex lens. A ray of light which is passing through the focus, it will become parallel to the principal axis. And in case of concave lens, the ray of light which is directed towards the focus, it will become parallel after refraction. Now the image formation by convex lens. अभी मैंने आपको बताया अगर आपको मिरर आता है अच्छे से तो आप लेंसेस कर सकते हो. Do revise mirror at home. Make the ray diagrams of mirror or iske exactly similar hai. This is just for your reference. Ye sirf hum comparison ke liye use karenge. Concave mirror ka first case kya hota hai? When object is placed between pole and focus, right? And we get virtual, erect and magnified image. Ye bilkul similar vaisa hi hai. Dekho, object is placed between F1 and O. Theek hai? One ray is parallel. The parallel ray will pass through the focus. The second ray will pass through the optical center. Now extend these two rays backwards or aise appear hoga ki ye dono rays actually is point se aa rahi hain, a point se. So we get a magnified virtual image here, virtual erect and magnified image here. Aur kahan pe form ho raha hai? On the same side of the lens as the object. Jahan object hai usi side pe. Okay, please pause the video and draw the ray diagram side by side. You need to practice this a lot because this is very, very important. Next is when object is placed at focus. Ab isme focus pe place tha to kaisa tha? The image is formed at infinity. Similarly here, when the ray is parallel, it passes through the focus and the second ray passes through the optical center, right? And image is formed at infinity. Real inverted and highly magnified image. Second, when object is placed between F1 and 2F1, ये कौन सा case से मिलता है? When object is placed between F and C in case of concave mirror. तो image कहाँ form होती है? Beyond C. Characteristics भी same होते हैं. Okay, object is placed between F1 and 2F1. Parallel ray, it will pass through focus. The second ray will pass through optical center. And image is formed beyond C2. ठीक है? When object is placed at 2F1, that means ये वो वाला केस है, at C वाला केस. 2F1, parallel ray, it will pass through focus. The second ray will pass through optical center, and you will get image here at 2F2, but on the other side. But on the other side, okay? Real inverted and same size image. Next, when object is beyond 2F1, ये कौन सा केस से मिलता है? When the object is beyond C, parallel ray, then passing through focus, the second ray passing through optical center, and image is formed between F2 and C2. Okay, real inverted and diminished. When object is at infinity, parallel rays, they are meeting at focus. Real inverted image is formed and highly diminished image is formed. Now image formed by concave lens. Convex mirror mein kaise tha? Convex mirror there were only two cases for convex mirror. Ek tha infinity aur dusra tha anywhere between pole and infinity. So infinity ka humne kaise kiya tha? The rays get diverged aur aise appear hota tha ki focus se aa rahe hai. So virtual image is formed at focus. Aur isne kya tha? One ray is parallel, so it diverges and it appears that it is coming from focus. And second ray is towards the center of curvature. Center of curvature and it retraces the path. Can you see this? This is retracing the path because center of curvature ke towards ja rahi hai. And it appears that the rays are meeting here. So virtual, diminished and erect image is formed here. Bilkul same waise yahan pe. First case is the image is at infinity. The object is at infinity. Image is formed at focus. Second, the object is between infinity and O. Parallel ray, it diverges, then a ray through optical center, and it appears that the rays are meeting here, and you get virtual erect and diminished image between F1 and O. Okay. One important thing which I want you to understand is, see the when the ray is coming parallel, humne bola ki parallel ray hoga wo. फोकस से पास करेगा आफ्टर रिफ्रैक्शन. ओके, बट वी हैव टू फोकस हियर. एक इस फेस का फोकस है और एक इस राइट फेस का फोकस है. किस रे किस फोकस पे मीट करेगा वो कैसे पता चलता है? सी द रे इज इंसिडेंट ऑन दिस फेस, है ना, ये वाला लेफ्ट वाला फेस. तो इस लेफ्ट फेस का आप स्फीयर कंप्लीट करेंगे तो उसका फोकस यहाँ पे आएगा. So you will use this focus. उल्टा मत कर देना. Children do make this mistake. वो क्या करते हैं? वो ऐसे focus में convert कर देते हैं. No, this is wrong. Okay? तो ray जब यहाँ से आ रहा है तो आप इस वाले face का focus use करेंगे. Fine? And similarly in the concave lens, जब ray parallel है, it is falling on this surface. तो इस surface का focus यहाँ पे है. तो इससे diverge होगा ray. Okay, it will appear that the ray is diverging from this focus.